A very good morning to everyone. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th Feb, on the front page you have the coverage, Parikkar downplayed concerns of officials, file notings show. So this is the exclusive coverage which the Hindu gave regarding the file notings of the Rafael deal. And in this, the red flag was raised over PMO's parallel negotiations on Rafael purchase. But then Defence Minister Manohar Parikkar, it shows, downplayed these concerns of the officials. Then this is NSA slapped on two in MP for illegal cow transport. So we have seen how National Security Act, which is a stringent draconian act, the provisions of this act are slapped against two in Madhya Pradesh for illegal cow transport. Then below you have government grants divisional status to Ladakh. So in Jammu and Kashmir, the governor has granted Ladakh a divisional status. So there is a new administrative unit of Jammu and Kashmir which has been established. So it's Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh, the three divisions in the state now. Then seven get life term in Muzaffarnagar riots case. So this is the Muzaffarnagar riots case. We have discussed about it, how they, this was a case of 2013 in Uttar Pradesh. So around 60 people were estimated to be killed and many were displaced, thousands were displaced, and they are still living in camps, displaced from their place. And in this case now, the court has sentenced seven persons to life imprisonment. Then below here you have 26 dead in UP Hooch tragedy. Toll may go up. So this is a case of local liquor, you know, spurious liquor which has been drunk by many people and they have died post. So such Hooch tragedies are also common. We hear about them in news, and in this case too, the death toll is quite high. So then below you have startups to be listed for angel tax exemption. So we have been seeing how startups have been demanding angel tax exemption, and in this the notification would be issued by the government in a few days now. On page 2 you have Supreme Court issues notice to owner of Meghalaya coal mine. So the person was responsible for the illegal mining due to which the mishap took place, the San mine, in which 15 people have been trapped and for nearly 2 months now. So in this case the Supreme Court has issued notice to the owner of this Meghalaya coal mine. On page 5 you have Vet Institute ambulances mooted in 98 crore lion conservation program. So the central and Gujarat government have announced project that includes a wildlife crime cell. So this would be established in Gujarat. So it has, we have seen that at least 20 lions in Gujarat succumbed to a virus in 3 months ago. So now the government is taking steps for conservation of the Asiatic lion. The Asiatic lion conservation project has been provided 97.85 crores. Then this is avalanche kills 7 in Jammu and Kashmir Kulgam. It's another disaster which has struck here in Jammu and Kashmir. Victims include 5 policemen. 3 others were rescued from under several feet of snow. Then below you have medical devices to be treated as drugs. So the central government has come up with a notification which says that medical devices like all implanted devices, CT scans, PET and MRI equipments, defibrillators, dialysis machines, bone marrow separators will all be treated as drugs for human beings with effect from 1st April 2020. So this has been the decision taken by Drug Technical Advisory Board. It is said majority of medical devices are completely unregulated in India. So this is a step taken to regulate them by classifying them under drugs. Then this is TB survivors challenge patent extension for latest drug. So this is regarding the drug used to treat multi-drug resistant TB, Bedaquiline. So Johnson & Johnson holds the patent for Bedaquiline, and this patent has been extended presently, which has been challenged by 2 TB survivors. So this is there. So if the monopoly of Bedaquiline continues, then this Bedaquiline, which is one of the 2 latest drug to combat the disease, then it would become difficult for TB patients to get the medicine. Because if J&J gets the patent for it, it becomes its monopoly, then it can charge any price it wants. So drug would not be available at affordable prices, and that would affect the TB patients in the country. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the Jharkhand way. So this is regarding how the opposition in Jharkhand, it's better to focus on state level coherence in alliances, because there are various alliances which are being formed. The Congress alliance is with 3 regional parties in Jharkhand. So this is being spoken of. The opposition should focus on state level coherence in alliances, but they are aligning based on central government to be formed. Then this is Nigerian Renewal. So this is Muhammadu Buhari. So his mixed record in office makes the presidential contest an open race. So this is regarding Nigerian president. So he seeks re-election. The lead article, surveying India's unemployment numbers. So this has become very controversial. So it has been shown in the recent reports that how India's labor participation rate is very low by world standards, and it fell sharply after demonetization. Women bore the major brunt. Then this is 40 years after the Iranian Revolution. So this is how a political change is required in Iran too, but it will not be easy. Because there are again concerns here, Iran. So in Iran, the Iran country is actually targeted by USA too. So this is basically, though Iranian Revolution was against monarchy, but then gradually we saw after the Iranian Revolution the clerics, the religious leaders again got control and began to lead the governments. Then on Saturdays on Op-Ed page you have a Ground Zero coverage. So here this is regarding a Himalayan travesty. So this is regarding sex trafficking. So survivors of sex trafficking in Nepal were shocked when a local politician convicted of selling young Nepali girls to brothels in India was released by the Supreme Court of Nepal. So this is the entire case here spoken of. Then on page 8 you have Supreme Court tells Mayawati to pay for statues. So this is regarding the statue Smarak scam which has come forth in Uttar Pradesh, and this is a case of then Mayawati government which was in power, the Bharatiya Samaj Party leader. So Supreme Court has indicated that its tentative view is that BSP leader Mayawati will have to cough up and pay back to the public exchequer the money she spent on erecting statues of herself and party symbol elephant in public parks across Lucknow and Noida. Then below you have Supreme Court declines stay on 10% quota. So the Supreme Court has declined to stay the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act of 2019, which provides 10% reservation in government jobs and educational institutions for economically backward in the unreserved category. So the case will be heard by the Supreme Court, but it has declined to stay, put a stay on it. Then this is Chidambaram says imposing NSA on cow smugglers wrong. So this is the front page news too. And now this mistake has been pointed out to the MP government, the Congress government in Madhya Pradesh, by the leadership of Congress. Then this is again the same coverage which was in yesterday's front page too, plus even in today's newspaper. So regarding PMO's role in Rafael negotiations. But you can skip the entire page. The details which we have are enough. Even on the international page, there is no important news. On business page, you have US may end zero tariffs for India. So this is the latest downturn in trade ties of India with USA. So the India actually have new rules on FDI and e-commerce. So as a consequence of that, US may end zero tariffs for India now. Then below you have NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal, bars auditor for issuing false certificate. So this is regarding auditor Mukesh Choksi. So he had never examined the books of accounts of Zen Shaving Company. So and he gave the certificate. So this is called false certificate. And Mukesh Choksi, it is said, will not be eligible to be appointed as auditor for 5 years from now. On page 12, you have GOM favors GST cut on houses under construction. So a group of ministers, GOM, has favored lowering GST on under construction residential properties to 5% from present 12%. So they also propose reducing levy to 3% on affordable houses. There's no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. Even the monthly compilation has been uploaded here, and you can download the PDFs for daily current affairs too out here, which are freely available. For detailed video coverage on current affairs, you can enroll for our course. The details of that course is provided here. So that is it. Thank you.